Harvard University was founded in 1636 by the Pilgrim Fathers, who settled and organized the Massachusetts Bay Colony. It grew and flourished and rose to the pinnacle of American education, commanding the respect and admiration of a nation to which it gave educated men and great leaders. Harvard was first, the best. Harvard is ruled by a 32-man board of overseers, or trustees, according to the charter. In practice, decisions were made by a 7-member council that includes President Pusey, Treasurer George Bennett, and 5 alumni. This system of governing the university was at the heart of the April crisis at Harvard. ROTC and university expansion were the symptoms. The deeper issue of governing of the university was the one on which radicals and moderates could find common ground. With the campus gripped by an angry student strike, the Harvard faculty convened on Friday, April 11th. It was to be a long meeting, as Professor of History Oscar Handlin indicated on his way to that meeting.
Professor Handlin, I believe HRV News, how do you expect this meeting to go today?
Slow.
The meeting of the faculty lasted 4 hours. And at the end, Dean Franklin Ford read a resolution passed by the faculty.
The Faculty of Arts and Sciences deplores the forcible occupation of University Hall on April 9th. Responsibility for the events that follows falls in the first instance upon those who forced their way into the building, who forcibly ousted the officers of the university at work there, and who insisted upon remaining long after they were requested to leave. As members of a community committed to rationality and freedom, we also deplore the entry of police into any university. Some of us believe the decision to use force to vacate the building was wrong. Some of us believe it was unwise. Some of us consider it unavoidable, though regrettable. The university is at a crisis which requires unity of thought and action to preserve its enduring values. The university now lacks any effective procedure by which faculty and student opinion in the several faculties of the university can be consulted in the handling of acute emergency situations. We therefore propose the following resolution. Resolved, A, that all criminal charges relating to Harvard students and faculty be dropped. B, that this faculty elect a committee to investigate the causes of the present crisis, assume full responsibility for the disciplining of the students involved in the forcible occupation of University Hall, and consult with the representatives of the other faculties of the university and with student representatives in order to recommend changes in the governance of the university.